Welcome back, Sports This Morning on China's Television. We're taking a look at the 2017 African Cup of Nations. Let's continue, shall we? Joseph Atewa is with us in the studio. Joseph, so much confidence you have on the indomitable Lions of Cameroon. You said they will go on to win. Well done on live TV. You said so.
well, they will.
But they go on against Ghana. The Black Stars defeated DR Congo. Look at DR Congo and the Cameroonians. They play almost the same kind of football. Ghana defeated them. Where are you getting the confidence that Cameroon will beat Ghana?
Well, I think for the Ghanaians, no doubt they've got the players, you know, to upset any team and get to the final. They've got the experience when it comes to the African Cup of Nations. But going against the indomitable Lions, as I said earlier on, you look at the old us at Ghana, the likes of, I'm talking about Andrew Ayew. Yep. You have Asamoah Gyan, who will be missing tonight. He won't be playing tonight because of his injury. So, I mean, that's a big blow for the Ghanaians. Going forward, they might struggle. Well, they have a day. They're going for the might struggle. And I think for this Cameroonian side, look at the way they play. They play from the flanks. They have one man in center who can definitely convert those chances. And that might play for them tonight in that one. And the stats still remains the same. You look at head-to-head, the last three meetings, as I said, the last six meetings, it's all about Cameroon. So I think with the young and vibrant players they have, with the caliber of, and the coach, rather, they have in place, I mean, Cameroon all the way.
Okay, Cameroon on the way. You know what, Black Stars, how they got this far? We'll just take a look at some of their games, how they started from the very beginning. And, of course, they ended on a high.
In this opening match in Group D, to get the Black Stars underway. He's up against the best goalkeeper in Africa. He beats him. Dede Ayew celebrates. Physicality to this game. Expected nothing less from these two West African powerhouses. Yes, Jordan Ayew now with a chip. Hit a goal! Magnificent! And who else but Asamoah Gyan? That's what you want from your skipper. Wonderful cross and stuck away. And are they riding into the quarterfinals, the Black Stars? Worth looking at again and again and again. The power of the shot from Salah. And look at the wall just breaking up there. Boy, who gave away the free kick, and Andre Ayew left a perfect gap.
Oh, it's done well. Jordan Ayew! Klaksik bangs Ghana into the lead with a moment of individual brilliance.
Have been a fair bit more yellows here in the second half as the strike comes in from range. Oh, it's a blinder! Click, click, you know what that means.
Ayew sends the keeper the wrong way, comfortably slots it home. It's Ghana that lead once again. So it's Ghana that advanced to the semis, joining Cameroon and Burkina Faso.
Well, and that's how they got this far. It's going to be very painful not to see Matempe. That's, you know, bottom dance and all that, the bomb dance he does. But then you have the Ghanaians also giving their own style, but actually won them in the final again. Because I just want to see that dance style tomorrow. All right.
Joseph, I'm just saying.
That's what will be happening with that.
Yeah, because Cecilia Tayo, Joseph, you wouldn't want to see this Ghanaian team cry again. Last edition was a sweet, and they're saying to themselves,
still remember those scenes,
you
right?
Know, and they're saying to themselves, we've come this far, we cannot lose it this time around.
Well, I mean, they might say that to themselves. You look at Ghana, they mean the only team that have got into the semis in the last six AFCONs, a massive record. But so you ask yourself, in the last six AFCONs, you've got into the semi finals, what have you done? Okay, after so the 10th, 4th, I mean, after the 10th, 4th, and 5th time, why didn't you do so much, you know, to get to the final? Why this time around? I don't think they will qualify to the final at the expense of Cameroon, because look at the Cameroonian players. I insist these are young and vibrant players that are ready to go anytime, any day. So they will do everything possible. It might end on the spot because Ghana definitely will push them to the wall. But trust me, with the caliber of players they've got, talking to the Cameroonian team, they should go on to the final.
Okay. Yes, I did. Now, Ghana, when was the last time they won the Nations Cup? 1982. This is huge.
They've been waiting for a long time.
No heartbreak anymore. Okay, maybe you're thinking it's better for them not to get there, so that we don't see tears as we saw the last 2015.
Wow. but Joseph, you've been talking about the vibrant players that Cameroon have in the team. I mean, would you say Cameroon, player for player, a better side than Ghana? If you want to look at the Ghanaian players, Kristinatsu, the Ayew brothers, Wakaso, Amate as well. So, all experienced players. Would you say they're better side?
Well, the same question Gary Neville asked some sport pundits. Player to player, would you put Leicester City player and Manchester United, even Chelsea or Manchester United? But they went on to win the league. So it's not about the player. It's about you playing as a team. That's what the African Cup of Nations bring to the table. We don't have 38 matches to prove yourself. We have just 7 matches. They know that for a fact. So they would go into this game. See, we have just one more game. We are one game away from winning the title. These players are 22-23. They know what this will do to their career. So they will go all out and win. So it's not about putting players to player. Even if you have a Zlatan playing for Ghana,
I get what
it doesn't matter tonight because all that matters, we would play as a unit and qualify.
Uh-huh, so yeah, but that matters is because Joseph thinks Cameroon is going to lead us.
So no, but you can't say, you can't underestimate the roles of the match winners and teams as well.
That's right.
I mean, the Ghanaians look like they've got more match winners in their side than Cameroon.
Well, they must take their chances if they want to advance. Talking about Ghanaians at this point, if they take their chances in front of goal, they might go through. I mean, don't rule out the chances of Ghana getting to the final. Well-experienced team. And as I said, 6-time semi-finalists in the African Cup of Nations, they might just want to make this a last, you know, and get to the final. So don't take it away from them. But I think for me, you look at Ghanaian squad, the last 3 matches, they managed to score 2 or 3 goals, if I'm correct, or 2 goals, I mean, compared to the Cameroonians. Yeah, Cameroonians have also scored, you know, in front of goal, but their defense for me has been solid rock, and that will count tonight. So for me, you look at the stats, everything going into tonight's game is Cameroon all the way. I can put $1 million on that.
Okay. Dayo,
okay. I'm listening to Joseph. I'm getting some of the points. He's talking about Cameroon before they came to this competition. A lot of problems with administration. Players backed out saying, oh, we don't like what the federation they're doing. Ghana, in terms of what he said also about taking chances, Ghana, if they keep getting to the semis and the finals and they're not winning, then they're not
they taking chances. Bother. They shouldn't bother to get to the
semis. And if you've won once since 1982, change the approach.
We're just going to give Joseph one more chance to see if he's going to change his mind or not. Cameroon on Monday did not boycott their training because of bonuses issues. I mean, do you think that's going to affect them tonight against Ghana?
Well, I don't think that because it goes beyond the world. They protested, you know, that they want their bonuses and allowances. They want more money.
Okay.
But I think when it comes to the pitch of play, when it comes to match day, they know what is at stake. See, it goes beyond the $10,000 or $5,000 they will receive from the FA. If they win the African Cup of Nations, players, the youngsters you have in that squad will get bigger clubs, more endorsement for them. So they know what is at stake. They would go into this game with all their strength and get the job done.
And it would be a story of the side who couldn't do it.
He's not changing his mind.
All right, this is just got a big one. Now, let's move to the English Premier League now.
I know Cecilia likes this one.
Cecilia couldn't wait.
Come on, what would you be talking about? Like Nations Cup, like, okay, let's just flip it to the other side.
You want to
go to England, and we go to the goalless, and the 4-0. Okay, I won't go to Old Trafford. First of all, I'll go to the
Wembley,
of course, exactly, to London Stadium, where West Ham playing at home again. No Dimitri Payet. I mean, the first half, you had 3 goals already in the box. And in the second half, it was 4-1. And you have Yaya 4-0. You have Yaya Toure, you know, converting from the penalty spot. Now, Gabriel Jesus, that boy, I think he's coming into Manchester City. Maybe this summer, Kelechi Iheanacho should start thinking of going on loan or somewhere. But then there you have the result from last night. Manchester United and Hull City ended goalless. And Stoke City and Everton, it ended 1-1. And for Peter Crouch, he was able to make his 100th goal. Wow.
He's joined the 100 club now.
Yeah, and there's so few, you know. So you give
him 36. Age is nothing but a number, Austin. I always say that every time. You can see what Aladri is doing at 44.
Yeah.
It's all about, you know, taking care of yourself, being a model professional, and with a bit of luck.
Staying in shape.
Yeah. That's taking care of yourself.
But
quickly, you know, for Manchester United, I think a lot needs to be done. About Manchester United. Their third consecutive draw,
back
I beg your pardon, that one in the Premier League. Well, some will say they were created on the 6th day, I mean, to remain at that position. But jokes apart, you look at the caliber of players at Manchester United. See, we bought a Paul Pogba for more than £80 million because we believe as a game changer. So, I mean, the likes of Ander Herrera can do the same job. But you bring in a Paul Pogba, you expect him to start delivering. It goes beyond the passes. You have a Zlatan Ibrahimovic. So I think these players need to do more. They need to understand, see, a lot has been spent on us. We need to deliver. And I expect Manchester United.